Later today, we interview Councillor Udina. This relentless advocate for humanity has ruffled some feathers and has no plans to stop. Tune in and learn what the man the Turian hierarchy called a diplomatic incident waiting to happen has to say about humanity's role in galactic affairs.
Eyes straight ahead.
Go away. The envoy to the female clans doesn't have to listen to aliens.
I have nothing to say to aliens or their pet Krogan. You go beyond yourself, Gadatag Uvank. The rights of Erdnot are dominant. How do we know it will challenge him? He's unnatural. The beasts of the right could ignore him like a lump of plastic. They know blood no matter the womb. Your barking does not help your case. I'll speak for myself. This is the tank bread. It is very lifelike. Smells correct as well. Your protests ring hollow, Uvank.
I'm not fighting over this nonsense. Grunt's ready. Let's get to it.
I like your dismissal of our rituals even less than Uvank's challenges. And my word determines whether a rite will proceed.
If this must stand on ritual, then I invoke a denial. My Krant stands against him. He has no one.
My patience is tested, but Uvank invokes correctly. Grunt, who is your Krant? Your allies willing to kill and die on your behalf?
Grunt will strengthen Clan Erdnot. Name our target and it will die.
Spoken well. Most aliens, and some Krogan, do not understand our ways. I believe this human does.
Aliens don't know strength. My followers are true Krogan. Everything about Grunt is a lie.
You dare. I like this human. She understands.
I withdraw my denial. This will be decided elsewhere.
You have provoked them. Reason enough for me to like you. They're your problem now.
Do we need any special equipment?
To begin the rite, only the candidate and his Krant are required. You love battle, don't you, Shepard? The last gasp of a dying opponent. Bring your love of the fight to Grunt's trial, and he will succeed.
Is that Krogan gonna be a problem?
He is forbidden to interfere, will he? During the rite of passage, you must be ready for anything, Shepard. From what you've shown me, you will not disappoint.
We've waited long enough. Tell us how this works.
Still your impatience, Shepard. For now, know that Grunt will be tested, and that you must adapt.
We're ready. Let's do this.
Excellent. This is T'Chanka's most recent scar. The last surface city to fall in the rebellions. The Keystone was at the heart. It has survived wars and the passage of centuries. It endures. Like the Krogan. If you wish to join Clan Erdnot, you must contemplate the Keystone
and its trials.
What will happen?
Uno, you must adapt. You must thrive, no matter the situation. Any true Krogan will.
Let's get started, Shepard. Hit the keystone.
Then the Krogan were lifted to the stars to destroy the fear.
borders of a galaxy. An enemy only we could chase to their lair.
Crawlers, come to your death.
Enemies on our right!
Keystone. We must have to trigger it again for the next part of the rite.
Now, all Krogan bear the Genophage. Our reward, our curse. It is a fight where the only goal is survival.
Feel that? Everything is shaking.
Thank you. have company.
Good. I want more.
You live, and you brought down the Thresher Maw. No one has done that in generations. Erdnott Rex was the last.
My Krant gave me strength beyond my genes, which are damn good.
This will cause discussion. I wonder. You say you are pure, no alien meddling in your construction, just the Warlord Okir.
Come on, Uvank. You want to try killing him? Give it your best shot.
Not yet. This deserves consideration.
Why? I'm not getting any more natural.
You are powerful. You are a mistake. But your potential could tip the current balance of the clans.
You spit on my father's name, on Shepard's name. But now you stop ranting because I'm strong.
With restrictions. You could not breed, of course, or serve on an alien ship. But you'd be clan in name.
You talk like he's a thing. You're after his power. You don't really want him in your clan.
Of course not. I didn't really want to cooperate with Clan Erdnott either, but I had to. Clan Gadatog is on the verge, either of greatness or of joining the dust. I get traditional support if I fight you, and reformer support if I back you. Your rite of passage tipped that balance too.
Grunt can't settle for that, and I'm sure not allowing him to leave my crew.
It doesn't matter what you'd allow. Your authority doesn't go that far.
No, Gadatog. Whatever order you about is that repulsive alien dares to.
Shepard may piss me off now and then, but they drain my tank for droppings like you. You're dead.
You have passed the rite of passage, earning the honor of clan and name. Many survive, but it has been years since a Thresher Maw fell. Your names shall live in glory. Grunt, you are Erdnot. We now own property. Join the army and apply to serve under a battlemaster.
Shepard is my battlemaster. She has no match.
Understood. Congratulations, Erdnot Grunt. Accept this token from Fortak. His weapons are the finest we have.
What were you called before you became shaman?
I gave up my name when I became the shaman. I am a conduit for the rage and bloodlust of my people. It would be wrong to retain my old identity. My life belongs to the clan.
I want to know about T'Chanka's past.
T'Chanka is a place of great gifts. It kills the weak, torments the slow, and destroys the stupid. Survival is an honor, and here, Krogan thrive. We cover this planet with our civilization, only to burn it to the ground a dozen times over. Each time, we grow stronger. When we are wise and powerful enough, we will tame the planet forever.
I've never heard anyone say that wiping out their own civilization was a good thing.
I'd have thought you, of all aliens, would understand, Shepard. The Krogan empires and clans of the past were glorious, built in great battles and conquests, but their cores were weak. How else could they have fallen? When Krogan civilization achieves its apex, there will be no stopping it, no stopping us.
Tell me about Krogan rites and ceremonies.
You have seen the rite of passage. Krogan suffer the rite of life at birth, and the rite of honor when they wish to be considered for breeding. The rite of firsts is suffered before a Krogan faces a new enemy. A clan leader also undergoes many rites in service to the clan.
I don't need to listen to any more of this.
It is clear you would not hear anyway.
Oh, what's this?
Killed the Thresher Maw on foot.
I may be young, but I relay the wishes of the females. That's important.
You don't have the plates to try.
2 years since the destruction of the Destiny Ascension, planning for the fleet of the new Allied Citadel Defense Unit have reached another impasse.
You hear that the Tankbird and the human killed the Thresher Maw?
Everybody's heard. Hasn't been done since Rex himself.
You just can't help making trouble. No one has killed a Maw since my turn in the right. Next you'll tell me he's a Quint and craps dark matter. Guess that's what it takes to replace me. You are Erdnot Grunt. Welcome.
I need to go. We'll go over this another time.
Watch yourself, Shepard. T'Chanka isn't safe and homey like Pharaoh's.
I barely survived the Maw during my rite.
Guess that human's got a quad.
Erdnot clan reports use weak encryption. I see references to a captured Solarian in the logs of the chief scout.
And the Solarians, too.
Go to the clan leader. Erdnot Grunt, you can go where you want.
I have work for you if you want it, Erdnot Grunt. Just set the human aside and we can talk.
Thank you. Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal. Samara wants a moment with you.
Not grunt. I like it. I have a clan. That makes me... It makes me want to fight, not just able to. At Uvink, I wanted to disembowel him, to tear out his spine like a trophy.
Can you focus that on our real enemy, or do I have to lock you up for the ship's safety?
I get it now. It's part of what I am. Was just delayed because of being tank bred. Now that I know it's not an outside thing, and I have a place as a Krogan, I like it. Our enemies are in trouble, Shepard, and we better not run out of targets.
I need you to stay in line, Grunt. If you can't stay focused, you're a danger.
I'd never stab you in the back, Shepard. Warriors like you and me, straight to the face. Kidding, kidding. Shepard.
Just checking in. How are you doing?
Humans talk too much. Like the tank. Come back later.
That's all for now.
Shepard.
I can't believe the Collectors were once Protheans.
I always pictured Protheans being regal, not giant bugs.
Who knows what the Reapers did?
I am glad you came. I must ask for your help. That is not easy for me.
What do you need?
When we met on Ilium, I told you about a very dangerous person I was pursuing. Using the information you obtained, I have located her. She's been going by the name Morinth. I would like to apprehend her before she disappears again.
Didn't you say you'd pick up her trail after our mission?
I know where she is, right now. In a month, she may be gone. This is the best opportunity I've ever had.
Where is she?
Omega. A nightclub called Afterlife, which seems a perfect place for her to hunt.
How important is this?
Killing her has been my focus for 400 years. It is the most important thing in my life, and the reason I became a Justicar.
Tell me about her.
She is an Ardat Yakshi. It is a term from a dead Asari dialect. It means demon of the night winds, but that is mythology. She is simply a very dangerous woman who kills without mercy.
You're dangerous too.
As are you. But she is different. Morinth suffers a rare genetic disorder. When she mates with you, there is no gentle melding of nervous systems. She overpowers yours, burns it out, hemorrhages your brain. You end up a mindless shell, and soon after, you are dead.
Why isn't this ever mentioned in Asari literature or art?
When we were primitive, there was much fascination with Ardat Yakshi. Some cultures worshipped them as gods of destruction. Now the Asari have a place in the galaxy, and they don't wish this defect to be widely known. As far as I know, only three exist today. Two chose a life of seclusion. The third ran.
Morinth.
She ran, and I am sworn to kill her.
I don't know that I blame her for running.
When she fled, she proved her addiction. She was not taking a great moral stand. She simply wants to keep killing. She is a tragic figure, but not a sympathetic one.
Can't she abstain?
Each encounter gives her strength. The effect is narcotic. The more she does it, the more she needs to do it. She will never stop. She can't.
So you hunt down these Asari just because they're born with a genetic condition?
It manifests with maturity. When one is diagnosed, she is offered the chance to live in seclusion and comfort. If she refuses, it shows her addiction to the ecstasy she gets from killing her mates. There is no redemption for such a person.
They have to choose between prison and death.
It is an addictive condition. Remember how adaptive we are. If Morinth does not want to be cured, she won't be.
Isn't she only deadly to the people she mates with?
Each time she kills, she becomes stronger, smarter, and faster. And she's been doing this for 400 years. She confuses her victims, twists their feelings. They will do anything for her favor.
If we have time, we'll deal with it.
There is one thing more. This creature, this monster, she is my daughter.
I needed to know this a long time ago.
I present no danger to anyone besides my own children. And this is not easy to speak of, even 400 years after I learned it. My daughter's condition is my fault, and my redemption lies in killing her. Do not pity me. Simply understand my situation.
How did all this happen?
I spent my youth on the move, adventuring. I killed people, mated with them, or just danced the night away. I learned so much, experienced so much, and then my matron days came. I could finally sit back, bask, and enjoy my family. But in one moment, it was all taken away.
We've all suffered, Samara.
I'm not asking for your pity. I am trying to explain why this is so important to me. Shall I stop?
Keep going. I'm listening.
I sat in a med lab while a nearsighted doctor droned at me, and I learned that nothing was as I thought it would be. I gave up all that I possessed. I own nothing, claim nothing. All my knowledge will die with me. Now my purpose is to destroy my own children.
You either get stuck in your past or forget it and move on.
I am not stuck in my past. I am out to rectify it. Help me find my long-lost daughter. And kill her.
If there's time, maybe we can go to Omega.